Thank you very much. It is such a great honor to be awarded such a prestigious research gift by the Brain Foundation. And I'm very thankful with you because you're supporting our research in Alzheimer's disease. I have a particular interest in Alzheimer's because it's the major type of dementia, as we just heard. And it affects the brain cells and the function of the brain, such as thinking and memory. And unfortunately, it is also a fatal disease. After 100 years since its discovery, we still have no cure in place. And this is mainly because there's a limitation studying the human brain, and also because the animal models that exist, they not fully recapitulate the disease. So this is why me and my colleagues are very interested in generating a human model to study Alzheimer's disease in the lab. And it's a very interesting and, I think, exciting time in the field because we have such an amazing technological advance in science. And we're taking advantage of these technologies to be able to model, to have a human model of Alzheimer's. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about these technologies. And what we can do now in the lab, we can generate stem cells from skin. So we can take skin biopsies from any of you, and we transform this skin into stem cells. These stem cells have the amazing capacity to differentiate or become any cell type of the human body, and this includes the brain. So as you can imagine, this is such an amazing technology, and it's a powerful tool because now we can make brain tissue that resembles a brain biopsy from cells that came from your skin. This tissue, it's known as cerebral organoids, or we call them mini brains. And we know that these tissues have different cell types that are affected during Alzheimer's disease. So what our aim is to, in an indirect manner, to take a brain biopsy from patients with Alzheimer's disease, but not by not affecting the brain at all, just by taking skin samples and transforming these cells into the mini brains. And hopefully with this award, we can specifically use a novel technology for gene editing called CRISPR that maybe some of you have heard, maybe not. But this technology allows us to directly manipulate genes. And now we can change the genes in these organoids, in these mini brains, and assess the effect of genes that are associated to the high risk of developing Alzheimer's disease. So thank you very much.